This hand's a keeper. Maybe we'll walk sack into a signet again. I mean, this hand, it could be a mulligan, as it's incredibly slow and does nothing. However, it does have pretty good mana, and it has pretty high potential. We have a bunch of signets in the deck, and who knows, maybe we'll be able to recover even if we don't get one. And now we don't necessarily, I guess the Thran Dynamo became not as useful. Although I guess we're not very vulnerable to Trigon Predator this game. So that's a plus. Sweet mana from the opponent. See if there's an accelerator. Fleece Mane Lion. Okay. No signet, so things are gonna be a little bit scary. But who knows, maybe we'll hit a balance. Maybe a Johnny plus Gideon will pull us back in and pull us ahead. See how things go. A Johnny Gideon combo is pretty nice. Maybe the opponent doesn't have a third land either. See if it's coming. There it is. All right. Avacyn's Pilgrim. Lots of little dudes. Okay, and there's the balance. My issue with playing balance. Well, we want to play balance. We would keep three cards. Yeah, we want to play balance just to not be taking a million damage here. Yeah, we definitely want to balance. Okay, so I'm going to keep a Johnny, Gideon, and a Swamp. That way, we can play a Johnny next turn, and any land we draw will turn on the Gideon. Could have not played a land, and the opponent would have had to sack a land, and then we could have played a land. Is that how that would have worked? Would we have wanted to do that? Potentially, that might have been. I might have played that a little poorly. Okay, hopefully there's something we can kill with a Johnny. It is awesome. We could minus. Ancient Grudge is not useful. We could minus. I'm gonna make I'm gonna plus one it so that the opponent can't play two creatures and get it back right away. However, this is vulnerable to another haste guy or something like that, so maybe that was a poor play. Scavenging Ooze is gonna be a big boy. Sweet, we have a Gideon. Plus two. No, we want a plus two. Make the opponent attack us. Target opponent, right? Plus two. You must attack us. And Vengevine remains tapped. So, really liking our spot here. The Ooze can get pretty big. 5/5, attacking the Gideon. So, that's definitely strong. I guess the Grudge maybe could have come out, but I bet. I mean, I'm scared of a sword or something like that coming down, or another haste guy, or stack of cards could crumble. Five drop is scary. Wake. Wolfhere Silverheart. Alright, well, this game just became impossible, just about. Need to hit a Terminus, I guess. I don't really know what we would want over. Yeah, I don't really know what we would want over the Grudge. So we're going to kill the Vengevine, chump the Silverheart or one of those with the get to encampment, and then we're going to, or maybe not, depending on how the opponent attacks, and then we're going to top deck a Terminus or an Elspeth three, and we have the mana for either. I'm gonna take the eight so that we have six mana to play an Elspeth. Although I could have chumped and then kept a Johnny alive. Maybe that would have been better. But I kind of want six to play an Elspeth. Didn't. All right, scoop. That game took a turn for the worse, and we might have been able to win by not playing a land before balance, as the opponent would have gone down on a land. Okay, cutting the grudge. Arc Trail seems pretty good from what we've seen. A couple small guys. Exalted Angel would be an option as well. Exalted Angel actually seems pretty good. Here. And Chandra seems not bad either. I'm gonna cut the Lodestone for Exalted Angel. And not put in the Chandra. And let's do it.